Today's topic is energy, and we know for work to be done, we require a body to get displaced under the action of some force. And this capacity of a body to do work, we will call this quantity as energy. So energy then can be defined as the capacity to do work. And therefore, whatever are the units for work would be the units for energy. Correspondingly, the dimensions for work and energy would be the same. All right. So the unit for work is, say, joule. The same would be the unit for, energy, friends. So let's understand energy in greater details. Basically, you will call it as the property of a system. Okay. So when I'm saying property of a system, then it means, there would be different types of energy in a system. So let's say different types means kinetic energy, potential energy, thermal energy, chemical energy, and so on. So a system may consist of so many energies. Okay, you measure it in joules, or the 1 joule can be represented as 1 Newton meter. Why? Because again, let's get back to the definition for energy. What is it? Capacity to do work. So, force into displacement is work. That's how you define 1 joule. So what is potential energy then? Let's have a understanding regarding, potential energy. So basically, object will have energy by virtue of its position in the field. Hopefully now I am audible clearly. So this object will possess some energy by virtue of its position. And such type of energy we call it as potential energy. Okay, hopefully you have understood this. So let's proceed further. When I'm saying position in a field, obviously this position would be, with respect to gravitational field or electromagnetic field. So correspondingly, we will define potential energy. Kinetic energy. Now, when we talk about kinetic energy, it's the energy possessed by a body on account of its motion. And potential energy is the energy possessed because of its location. Where is it located? At what height the object is located, and so on. So together, kinetic and potential energy will form something called as mechanical energy. Because this mechanical energy is needed for the work to be done. So mechanical energy includes kinetic energy as well as potential energy. So there is another type of energy, non-mechanical energy. Now let's understand what types of energies they come under the category of non-mechanical energy. So when I'm talking about non-mechanical energy, friends, the energy is related to chemical energy, thermal energy, nuclear energy, electrical energy, acoustic. Acoustic means sound energy. They all get categorized under non-mechanical energy. Now when we are talking about energy, we need to understand that energy will change forms. So let's get back to the law of conservation of energy. Now, what this law of conservation of energy says, the total energy in the system will remain constant. The energy may change its form. The kinetic energy will get converted into potential and vice versa. But the total amount of energy will always remain constant. That's what law of conservation of energy says. So you can see when a car moves, chemical energy will get converted into kinetic energy. Now, when I'm saying chemical energy gets converted into kinetic energy, the basic understanding is the fuel burns in the engine and the engine makes the car move. Okay, that's why we say the chemical energy is converted into kinetic energy when car moves. Other example, say for example, this person is trying to move this entire assembly on the floor. So obviously this kinetic energy ultimately gets converted into thermal energy. You will find where the friction takes place, it gets heated. So this kinetic energy, on account of its motion, gets converted into thermal energy. There will be some sound created. So this kinetic energy also gets converted into acoustic energy, friends. This is how the conversion of energies would take place into different forms. Now, when we are talking about the mechanical energy, say for example, let's say this stone is at some height, say h. Okay, here the stone will have some potential energy because of its height. And if you drop the stone, the height reduces. So initially, you can see the potential energy is high, and comparatively, the kinetic energy is comparatively low because it is still in the motion. So potential energy will get converted into kinetic energy. But whenever we talk about the energy, it would be in totality. So potential plus kinetic energy will be represented by this bar. All right. Now, what happens once the stone starts moving down? Okay. So let's see. The total amount of energy of a closed system always remains conserved. This is what the law of conservation of energy says. So I was talking about the stone which is moving down. So the potential energy is slowly getting converted into kinetic energy, but the total energy will remain constant. That's what it means. Okay. And the same thing is being shown with the help of the bar chart over here also, you can see. So by the time the stone moves down, the kinetic energy has increased. Correspondingly, the potential energy has decreased. Why? Because potential energy is being converted into kinetic energy. But in totality, if you add these two bars, you ultimately get the total energy remains conserved. This is what law of conservation of energy says. All right, now there can be some few examples where you can see elastic potential energy and kinetic energy are interconvertible. Say, for example, a spring block system. Now the block gets stressed, it presses the spring, kinetic energy gets converted into potential. The spring releases the block, potential energy gets converted into kinetic energy, and so on. The process will keep on happening. Here also, in this case, you can see the maximum kinetic energy if the bob of the pendulum is moving. Here at the center, at the mean position, you can see the kinetic energy is maximum. Here you can see the kinetic energy is maximum at the center. So at the center, potential energy will be zero. But by the time the bob moves to the extreme position, you see kinetic energy gets converted into potential energy. So at extreme, potential energy will be maximum and kinetic energy will be zero. At the mean position, kinetic energy will be maximum, potential energy will be zero. But somewhere midway, if you talk about, then you can see both the energy distributed in both the forms, okay, kinetic as well as potential equally. So depending upon the motion, now you can see the pendulum keeps on moving. The potential energy may get converted into kinetic, vice versa, kinetic gets converted into potential, but the total energy will always remain constant. So when I say total energy remains constant, friends, we can frame an equation for law of conservation of energy. So what equation we can frame, we will be talking about that equation in subsequent session. So here in this equation, you can see total mechanical energy, ME, would be equated as kinetic plus potential energy. The mechanical energy, for kinetic energy, the formula is half mv square. For potential energy, it is mgh, where m stands for the mass of the body, v stands for the velocity with which it is moving, g is acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height. So initial position, mechanical energy for the initial position will be equal to mechanical energy for final position. But then we can place it in form of an equation. So half mvi square plus mgh i stands for initial.
Yeah, friends, just a minute, okay? I'll get back to just a minute.
So here you can see half mvi square plus mgh i, where i stands for initial position, equal to half mvf square plus mgh f, where f stands for final position. Please make a note of it before we proceed further. We are going to use this equation time and again, or the situation time and again,
for solving problems on law of conservation of energy. Okay, so hopefully done. Let's proceed then. So here always remember this sum, okay, Ke plus potential energy will remain constant. You can always use this equation. I know you have noted down this equation. So let's move ahead then. So what I want to tell you is whenever we use this equation, often what we do is we don't consider friction. Now here is the methodology how to solve problems on conservation of energy. So plug in what you know. So whatever you know, you want to just put it over here and solve for what you don't. So some unknown has to be found out time and again. This is how the problems are framed on law of conservation of energy. Please make a note of it quickly. Okay, now in this problem, you can see there is a ball at the top, okay, at this particular structure, and the height is say 3 meter and the mass of the ball is 0.15 kg. Now obviously this ball is going to slide along this particular structure and finally it will come down over here, okay. So by the time it comes down, the potential energy which it was possessing at this point will get converted into kinetic energy over here. This kinetic energy again gets converted into some potential energy over here. And finally, when the ball comes down to the ground, it comes to rest. And here you can see the entire energy, potential energy, gets converted into kinetic energy. And what happens to this energy? Because the ball bounces over here, it will get converted into sound energy. Few dust particles over here will move. So it will amount to work done in this case, and so on. That means, you know, the energy will get transferred or transformed into different forms as per the law of conservation of energy, and the total amount of energy will remain constant. This is what this problem says. Then they are expecting the velocities at point A and B. Just now we have framed the equation, you can see. At this particular point, I can say zero kinetic energy, maximum potential energy. So let's place it in form of an equation. Okay, if I want potential energy at this point, it will be mg into h. H is 3 meter. Okay, this is the potential energy at this point. This is how you estimate potential energy at that point, topmost point. Now, when I'm saying I get the value for potential energy over here at the topmost point, and when I solve it, I get the value as 4.4 joule and kinetic energy at point number one or the topmost point is zero. Now mechanical energy is conserved. So at point number one, I can say kinetic energy at point one plus potential energy at point one will be equal to kinetic energy at point two plus potential energy at point two. But then Ke plus Pe at point one is 4.4 joule. So I'm going to put left hand side as 4.4 joule. Which I have estimated over here. Please make a note of it before we proceed further. So left hand side then would be substituted as 4.4 joule. And then you can have a look at it. Potential energy is getting converted into kinetic energy when the ball is coming down. So here you can see at this particular point, potential energy will be zero. So obviously what will be the kinetic energy? 4.4 joule. So whatever was the potential energy, it will get converted into kinetic energy before it hits the ground. Whatever was the kinetic energy gets converted into potential energy as per the law of conservation of energy. So this was about the first point and the final point. So there is an intermediary point over here, and here they want the velocity, right? So let's talk about that. So here 4.4 will be equated to half mv square. When you equate this, friends, only unknown is velocity, right? So we want to work out the velocity over here. When we solve it, we get the velocity as 7.66 meter per second. So by the time it is about to fall on the ground, the velocity comes out to be 7.66 meter per second. So please make a note of it before we proceed further. Okay. So at this point, you can
estimate potential energy. What will be the potential energy at this point? M, G, and H, 0.5. Okay, 0.5 is the height over here. Solve it. So I get the potential energy at this point as 0.74 joule. Right, now I get the potential energy over here. So kinetic energy plus 0.74 joule is equal to 4.4 as per law of conservation of energy. Here I will put the value for kinetic energy as half mv square. So ultimately I'll get kinetic energy equal to, you can see, 3.7 joule. I will equate this kinetic energy to half mv square. So you can see I'm equating it with half mv square. So the only unknown is v at this point. When you substitute and solve it, you get the velocity at this point equal to 7.0. And just before striking the ground, it was 7.66 meters. So this is how you solve problems based on law of conservation of energy. So you can see these examples demonstrate law of conservation of energy here. A bow and an arrow, you know, here a potential energy will get converted into kinetic energy in both the systems, you can check. Okay. So you can just have a look at it. You increase the height of the object, the potential energy increases. The height decreases, potential energy decreases. Correspondingly, when you go high, kinetic energy reduces. When you come down under the action of gravity, kinetic energy increases. So potential energy gets converted into kinetic energy, you can see. So whenever the ball falls down, the kinetic energy increases. And when you are lifting the ball upwards, the potential energy increases. Okay. So here you can see, whenever the system, in a system, when the ball moves down or it is about to reach the ground, the kinetic energy is maximum over there. Okay. Please make a note of it.